Hello there, how are you? I hope you are fine. Here I am with a new lesson again. This is the third tense lesson. That means we have already done two tense lessons previously. And today's lesson is about present simple tense. And this is the part B. That means we have already done the part A on the recent video. So today we are going to learn some more about present simple tense. So do you like to learn? If you do, please hang on to the video. Welcome to you at my today's class. These are the present simple tense structures that we have already learned in part A. And these are the structures that we are going to learn in today's class. Before we start to learn today's structures, listen to this song. You have heard it on our last video. The first four lines of this song are according to the structures that you learned in the part A of the present simple tense. And the rest of the four lines are according to the structures that we are going to learn today.
I'm a good student, I know my duties and rights. I'm a good student, I know my duties and rights. I have some responsibilities, I have some responsibilities. I have to fulfill them, I have to fulfill them. I should respect my elders. I love my youngers. I should respect my elders. I must wear my school uniform. I must wear my school uniform. I can do all these well. I can do all these well. I can do all these well.
Did you enjoy the song? I hope you did. Now, let's go to our today's lesson. Are you ready? So here we go. The fifth structure of present simple tense, affirmative or positive, subject plus should plus V1 plus sometimes object and Example, you should talk to her about it. You should talk to her about it. Another example, I should go now. I should go now. Negative structure, subject plus should not plus V1 plus sometimes object and Example, we shouldn't think much about it. We shouldn't think much about it. Another example, she should not ignore her studies. She should not ignore her studies. Now let's go to yes-no question of the same structure. Affirmative or positive, should plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object and Example, should I go there? Should I go there? Another example, should he do it now? Should he do it now? Negative structure, shouldn't plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object and Example, shouldn't we help them? Shouldn't we help them? Another example, shouldn't you be quiet? Shouldn't you be quiet? Now let's go to WH question structure A. Affirmative or positive? WH plus should plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object and Example, what should I do now? What should I do now? Another example, where should they build their house? Where should they build their house? Negative structure, WH plus should not plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object First structure, when shouldn't we speak? When shouldn't we speak? Another example, why shouldn't you do that? Why shouldn't you do that? WH question structure B, affirmative or positive. Who should plus V1 plus sometimes object dot dot question mark. Example, who should help you? Who should help you? Another example, who should follow these precautions? Who should follow these precautions? Negative structures. Who should not plus V1 plus object and dot dot question mark. Who should not plus V1 plus sometimes object dot 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 and question mark. Example, who shouldn't go there? Who shouldn't go there? Another example, who shouldn't take any drugs? Who shouldn't take any drugs? WH question structure C, affirmative or positive. WH plus object plus should plus subject plus V1 plus dot 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 question mark. Example, what type of food should we eat for good health? What type of food should we eat for good health? Another example, how many books should you have? How many books should you have? Negative structure. WH plus object plus should not plus subject plus V1 plus dot 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 question mark. Example, which animal shouldn't we kill? Which animal shouldn't we kill? Another example, whose room shouldn't I enter? Whose room shouldn't I enter? Let's go to another structure of present simple tense. That is structure 6. Affirmative or positive. Subject plus must plus V1 plus sometimes object dot dot dot. Example, we must follow the national law. We must follow the national law. Another example, you must arrive on time. You must arrive on time. Negative structure. Subject plus must not plus V1 plus sometimes object dot dot dot. Visitors must not provoke animals in the zoo. Visitors must not provoke animals in the zoo. Another example, you must not taste a poison. You must not taste a poison. Yes, no question. Affirmative or positive. Must plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object dot 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 question mark. Example, must we arrive at 10 every morning? Must we arrive at 10 every morning? Another example, must I pay the entrance fee? Must I pay the entrance fee? Negative structure. Mustn't or needn't plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object dot 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 question mark. Example, mustn't you wear your office uniform? Mustn't you wear your office uniform? Another example, needn't we get tickets for visiting the zoo today? Needn't we get tickets for visiting the zoo today? Here, mustn't means that you cannot do at any cost, and needn't means you just do not require to do. Now let's go to WH question structure A, affirmative or positive. WH plus must plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object dot 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 question mark. Example, where must I go today? Where must I go today? Another example, how must we do that? How must we do that? Negative structure. WH plus must not plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object and dot dot question mark. Example, when mustn't she take the medicine? When mustn't she take the medicine? Another example, why mustn't he go there? Why mustn't he go there? Now, WH question structure B, that is who question. Affirmative or positive. Who must plus V1 plus sometimes object dot dot question mark. Example, who must follow these rules? Who must follow these rules? Another example, who must finish the task? Who must finish the task? Negative structure. Who mustn't or needn't plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object dot 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 question mark. Example, who mustn't take that medicine? Who mustn't take that medicine? Another example, who needn't pay any tax? Who needn't pay any tax? Now, WH question structure C, affirmative or positive? WH plus object plus must plus subject plus V1 plus ... question mark. Example, which lesson must I prepare today? Which lesson must I prepare today? Another example, how much money must we pay as fine? How much money must we pay as fine? Negative structure, WH plus object plus mustn't or needn't plus subject plus V1 plus ... question mark. Example, whose name mustn't you forget? Whose name mustn't you forget? Another example, what sort of people needn't we listen to? What sort of people needn't we listen to? Now, let's go to structure 7th of the present simple tense. Affirmative or positive, subject plus can plus V1 plus sometimes object ... Example, I can swim in a big river. I can swim in a big river. Another example, you can enjoy picnic in the park. You can enjoy picnic in the park. Negative structure, subject plus cannot or can't plus V1 plus sometimes object ... Example, you cannot leave office before 5 p.m. You cannot leave office before 5 p.m. Another example, Vinayak can't play football today. Vinayak can't play football today. Yes, no question. Affirmative or positive? Can plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object ... question mark. Example, can you drive a car? Can you drive a car? Another example, can I take a short break? Can I take a short break? Another example, can you close the door, please? Can you close the door, please? Negative structure, can't plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object ... question mark. Can't he go to his office today? Can't he go to his office today? Another example, can't you do it right now? Can't you do it right now? WH question structure A, affirmative or positive? WH plus can plus subject plus B1 plus sometimes object ... and question mark. Example, what can I do for you? What can I do for you? Another example, when can Peter take a leave? When can Peter take a leave? Negative structure, WH plus cannot plus subject plus V1 plus sometimes object ... and question mark. Why can't you help her? Why can't you help her? Another example, where can't we smoke? Where can't we smoke? WH question structure B, that is who question. Affirmative or positive, who can plus V1 plus sometimes object ... and question mark. Example, who can stop the death? Who can stop the death? Another example, who can help me? Who can help me? Negative structure, who cannot plus V1 plus sometimes object ... question mark. Who can't speak Chinese? Who can't speak Chinese? Another example, who can't eat pizza? Who can't eat pizza? WH question structure C, affirmative or positive? WH plus object plus can plus subject plus V1 plus ... question mark. Example, whose umbrella can I borrow for a while, please? Whose umbrella can I borrow for a while, please? Another example, how much paper can we take from there? How much paper can we take from there? Negative structure, WH plus object plus cannot plus subject plus V1 plus ... question mark. Example, which vehicle can't you drive? Which vehicle can't you drive? Another example, what type of question can't you answer? What type of question can't you answer? Structure 8, our present simple tense, affirmative or positive. Subject plus ought to plus V1 plus sometimes object and ... question mark. Example, we ought to keep our area clean. We ought to keep our area clean. Another example, she ought to keep her promise. She ought to keep her promise. Negative structure, subject plus ought not plus be one plus sometimes object da da da. Example, we ought not to be rude to our parents. We ought not be rude to our parents. Here, often British English use to after ought not, and American English do not use to after ought not. Another example, you oughtn't to hurt her, or you oughtn't hurt her. Yes, no questions. Affirmative or positive. Ought plus subject plus to plus V1 plus sometimes object da da question mark. Example, ought I to write a letter of thanks? Ought I to write a letter of thanks? Another example, ought we to be there tonight? Ought we to be there tonight? Negative structure, oughtn't plus subject plus to plus V1 plus sometimes object plus da 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 question mark. I've already told you that often British people use to after ought and American people do not use to after ought. Example, oughtn't she to attend the meeting? Oughtn't she to attend the meeting? Another example, oughtn't you to ask her once? Oughtn't you to ask her once? In the Part A and Part B videos of this lesson, we learned 8 structures of present simple tense. If this video was helpful for you, please like and share it. And if you love to learn more grammar, please subscribe this channel, because I am giving the lessons on other tenses in my coming videos. You can follow or contact me on the links given in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. See you on the next video. For now, bye.